Hi guys, I'm Erik Voss, and Black Panther gave us not only one of the best Marvel movies to date, but some of the best new music we've heard for one of these movies. Kendrick Lamar's soundtrack, featuring collaborations from artists like The Weeknd, SZA, Vince Staples, and more, features powerful, deeply thematic lyrics, and it joins a film score of traditional African instrumentation by composer Ludwig Göransson, all to make Black Panther sound as amazing as Ryan Coogler makes it look. So in this video, I'm gonna run through the Black Panther movie and break down all the moments where the music, both the soundtrack and the score, snuck in some subtle, deeper meaning that you might have missed. That's right, this guy's gonna try to explain rap. Hey, they taught elephants how to paint, maybe we should all try new things. And yeah, spoiler warning in case you haven't seen Black Panther yet. Okay, the first song I wanna talk about is really one of the best songs on Kendrick Lamar's soundtrack, titled King's Dead, featuring J-Rock, Kendrick Lamar, Future, and James Blake. This track is really the anthem for Michael B. Jordan's villain character, Killmonger, channeling his inner monologue the moment he declares King T'Challa to be dead, and long live King in Jadaka. Actually, Kendrick Lamar gives him a shout out toward the end of the song. Now, in my in-depth breakdown of Black Panther, I pointed out how the characters of T'Challa and Killmonger reflect the long-time debate in the civil rights movement between figures like Martin Luther King Jr. and Malcolm X. King was known for preaching non-violent, symbolic gestures, while Malcolm X preached action and violence if necessary to combat racism in society, a philosophy Killmonger takes to an extreme. This track's title of King's Dead could also reflect the shift the civil rights movement took following that King's death, when many felt it signaled a time for more extreme action. And for something a little less heavy, I just love the nod Future gave the 3-6 Mafia here. This soundtrack's for a Disney movie. Guys, I love this. But let's move on to talk quickly about this movie's original score, composed by Ludwig Göransson. From the movie's earliest scenes, this composer identifies the hero and villain with opposing instruments that he discovered while traveling through West Africa for research. For T'Challa, he uses something called the talking drum, something that was used in Senegalese villages for communication. It can be adjusted for pitch to reflect the sound of the human voice. Meanwhile, for Killmonger, the composer used the fula flute, or tambin. You can hear the talking drum playing underneath several scenes throughout the film, including T'Challa's battle with M'Baku to claim the throne. But then later, when he battles Killmonger, the drum and the flute clash with each other in the music, just like the characters are clashing in their fight. In another scene, if you listen closely when T'Challa and Nakia stroll through the streets of Wakanda, Göransson samples more traditional West African music, this time from the country of Mali, a song called Bere Bere by Idrissa Sambaro featuring Ali Farka Touré. Apologies if I mispronounced any of that. Along with the shots of bumbling trolleys and vendors grilling chicken, this music makes the street level of Wakanda feel so grounded and authentic. Now, another example of traditional West African music being linked with a character, later on in the South Korean casino, director Ryan Coogler pointed out in an analysis of this scene another interesting musical cue.
Also, another thing is music here. You know, our composer Ludwig Göransson did some beautiful music, and this is where you hear the Dora cue. It's a group of women in Senegal doing a yip, like a choo, 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 choo.
Yeah, you can hear these Senegalese women chirping every time the Dora Milaje fights throughout the movie. Actually, if you listen closely, they come up during King's Dead as well. Actually, this whole sequence in South Korea is filled with interesting music samples. First, when they roll up in Busan, you can hear the song Hangover by Korean musicians Psy and Snoop Dogg. But then once they enter the club, the music shifts to another song from the soundtrack, Pray For Me by The Weeknd and Kendrick Lamar. The lyrics here explore the burdens of being a hero, how that responsibility often falls on one person's shoulders as they have to face these struggles alone. All this expresses what's going through T'Challa's mind here. He has just become the ruler of a nation, yet it's still on him to carry out the responsibilities of the warrior on this mission to be the hero. Next, when the action moves outside in this amazing car chase, the music shifts to the amazing track called Opps by Vince Staples and Yugen Blackrock. This music actually showed up in one of the later trailers for Black Panther, and while the beat and Staples' lyrics are just so intense and charged, the song takes on a whole new life in the second verse when Yugen Blackrock takes over. She's a young upstart rapper from South Africa, and her lyrics are just as proud and boastful as Staples are. Together, these two reflect T'Challa and Shuri's cooperation here. Shuri's driving the Lexus remotely and T'Challa's riding it, with the goal being to chase down Claw and the stolen vibranium. Ultimately, their takedown of Claw is reflected in these lyrics as well. When charged with stealing vibranium from Wakanda, Claw responds racistly, "You savages wouldn't know what to do with it." This idea of white colonizers plundering African resources and economic oppression is, yeah, one of the many things Staples targets with his lyrics. Okay, in the movie's final scene, T'Challa and Shuri visit the Oakland Project where their father killed their uncle. And the music being sampled here is Sleepwalking by Mozzie. Mozzie's from Northern California, like Ryan Coogler, so it looks like Coogler wanted to include a local artist for this scene. But when the credits roll, the music that plays is the big single from the soundtrack, All the Stars by Kendrick Lamar and SZA. Now, I highly suggest you check out the music video for this. It's beautifully shot, and it reflects a lot of the Afrofuturist aesthetic that production designer Hannah Beachler created for this movie. But really, it's SZA's chorus that underlies the theme of this moment. All the Stars Are Closer suggests that, for once, the oppressed and underprivileged are actually in arm's reach of their dreams. In this case, it's a kid on the streets of Oakland. He's closer than ever to a future he never could have imagined before. A badass superhero and king who looks like him, empowered by a magical element that originated from, as the movie's opening shots showed us, all the stars. But I'm curious to hear from you guys. Which of these musical cues got you most pumped while watching Black Panther? For me, those Senegalese women chirping during Ryan Coogler's awesome one-take tracking shot in the casino, guys, it was just perfect. But comment with your thoughts down below or tweet me directly at @EAVoss and follow New Rockstars on Twitter at New Rockstars for updates on our videos. And of course, subscribe to New Rockstars for more analysis of Black Panther. Check out my in-depth breakdown for all the movie's design details and Easter eggs. And for more music analysis like this, check out similar videos I did for the music of the Star Wars The Last Jedi and last year's Baby Driver. And if you really love us and you want to help us grow, you can contribute to this channel on Patreon. Big thanks to all of our donors, especially Wilhelmina Ebbeson. Guys, thanks for watching. Bye.